more than 14 years after September 11. Questions still remain about the role Saudi Arabia may or may not have played in the terrorist attacks that killed 3,000 Americans. After all, 15 of the 19 hijackers were from Saudi Arabia, and the Saudi intelligence agency had a long-standing relationship with Osama bin Laden, dating back to his days fighting the Soviets in Afghanistan. The 9/11 Commission also found evidence, or at least evidence of evidence, linking Saudi officials to the attacks. That evidence is discussed in a still-classified 28-page section of the 9/11 Commission report. If we're ever going to get anything close to an answer about whether the Saudis were even somewhat involved in 9/11, we're going to have to see those 28 pages. And that might just happen. The Obama administration now says that it plans on releasing those 28 pages sometime soon, although it's yet to offer any sort of a time frame for doing so. One thing the administration has said it won't do, however, is sign a bill that would allow the families of 9/11 victims to sue the Saudi government. Even though that bill has now passed both the House and the Senate, the White House press corps has made it very clear that it's not changing its mind on this issue. On Tuesday, after the Senate unanimously passed the bill, White House Press Secretary Josh Earnest said that President Obama still planned to veto it. He warned that it could have a serious impact on America's international commitments.
The United States is more engaged in activities in other countries and in any other country in the world. Typically, those are actually activities that other countries benefit from significantly. These are peacekeeping activities or humanitarian relief activities or other activities in which the United States is supporting the national security activities of other countries. And the national security of other countries is enhanced by the involvement of the United States. But our involvement in those activities is made more complicated by the chance that the principle of sovereign immunity could be eroded. So the administration strongly continues to oppose this legislation. We'll obviously begin conversations with the House about it.
But is that the real reason the administration is so opposed to the seemingly common sense bill? And why, if they have nothing to hide, are the Saudis lobbying so hard against it? Joining me now is Mike Papantonio, America's lawyer and host of Ring of Fire Radio and Ring of Fire TV. Pap, welcome back.
Tom, good to be here.
It's good to see you. So exactly what does the White House have against people trying to seek justice for their families?
There's no logical rationale here. We finally have this do-nothing Congress. They passed some meaningful legislation, and Obama has made it clear that he'll veto this legislation. Let me tell you why it's important. 15 of the 19 hijackers from 9/11 were from Saudi Arabia. And there's evidence that suggests that Saudi government funneled money to Al-Qaeda in the years, as you talked about, years prior to the attack. We also know that there are about 28 pages missing from the 9/11 report because they've been classified. Now, I don't expect anything to come out of what this administration is going to release. I can promise you they've looked at it. They're not going to release anything that interferes with this relationship that they think is so vital. I can tell you this, Saudi Arabia needs us far more than we need Saudi Arabia. And this love affair with these this entity has got to stop. I mean, this is not just a matter of the fact that they participated in murdering 3,000 Americans on our soil. That's not the type of thing that we grant governmental immunity for. It's far afield to what that concept is all about. So if he does this, I think there's enough votes to override it. I think they will override it. And finally, the families that are clear about the fact that the Saudis were participants in this are going to have a day in court where they can actually recover. It won't just be limited to that, though. This bill will allow other cases against the Saudi Arabians to take place. We focus on 9/11 because it was so horrendous, but there are many instances where you have citizens that need to proceed against Saudi Arabia. You have instances where Saudi Arabia is involved in actually financing some of the problems that soldiers face in Iraq. I mean, you have the IEDs that are going off. Some of that's financed through Saudi Arabia. There's no guesswork here. There are organizations in America that are trying to go after that money, and this administration has interfered with it all along the way.
Yeah. I'm trying to understand this. I get the whole, geopolitics of it. But, you know, what Josh Earnest said was that it was the principle of sovereign immunity. Might there be a concern, maybe even a legitimate concern, about tit for tat, essentially that, you know, we don't want our government to be suable, as it were, by other, by people, citizens of other countries. Once we drop that barrier for Saudi Arabia, is, you know, are we starting down a road that's dangerous, or is this?
That's always a concern, Tom. But I mean, virtually we're exposed in so many ways already. The point is this: sometimes you have to say there are some things that are so horrendous, and Saudi Arabia's participation it's very clear. I mean, there's been tons of information written about it. Ron Motley, before he died, he's a lawyer up in South Carolina. Joe Rice, Ron Motley, brought the first cases against the Saudis. They established a wealth of information to show that the Saudi government was involved and that Saudi charities were involved in funding 9/11. But not just 9/11. This goes far beyond 9/11. For Obama to stand there and say that this is just going to be to threaten the whole balance of immunity between various nations is not the right approach here. They have to be, these people need to have the opportunity to be made whole, as whole as they can. There's no way to make whole an individual who's lost their spouse or their child in something as horrendous as the murder that took place there at 9/11.
Yeah. I understand that Saudi Arabia has threatened to basically disinvest from U.S. treasuries. And then, as I recall, somebody from the Fed came out or somebody from the administration and said that they've only got a couple hundred billion dollars worth of treasuries to begin with, that they're not that big an investor. Am I remembering that right? Is this?
Well, they have about $700 billion in treasuries that they threaten to sell off. The truth is their ability to sell it off is almost non-existent. They're going to have an infrastructure that doesn't exist to sell it off. If they sell it off, fine, it'll happen. And then at the end of that, their economic position is going to be far worse than it is right now. Listen, you have a government here that is almost on their last leg where it comes to this international wealth that they've been able to spread around. There's questions about what their oil reserves are. There's questions of how long those are going to last. At every turn, they're threatened by insurgency all around them. I mean, without the United States, Saudi Arabia is in big trouble. So this threat, the gee whiz, we're going to take our ball and bat and go home. We're going to sell off our $700 million in treasury securities. It's absurd.
Bluster.